So now we can continue with our next paper from the Catholic University Leuven from Belgium, who's going to host this conference next year. So the contributors and authors of the next paper are Martin Kramer, Joran Kramer, David De Schepper, Peter Arts, Carol Cadens, Eric De Meester. So the paper is entitled Benchmarking Low-Cost Inertial Measurement Units for Indoor Localization and Navigation of AGVs. We are looking forward to your presentation.
My name is Jeroen Kramer. I'm a doctoral researcher at the Department of Mechanical Engineering of KU Leuven, and today I would like to present you our research concerning the benchmarking of low-cost inertial measurement units for indoor localization and navigation of automated guided vehicles. First, we will talk about our incentive to conduct this research and give a short description of the IMUs being examined. After that, we will dive deeper into the actual benchmarking, which consists of three parts: a static analysis based on the oft-recurring overlapping Allen variance method, and a dynamic analysis which compares the step and frequency responses of the IMUs while being subjected to motions similar to those observed during AGV operation. And finally, we will examine the quality of the maps being built by 2D SLAM using IMU and laser scan data of a production environment. At the end of this presentation, we will recap the results obtained in this research and point to some interesting future research tracks. In recent years, the landscape of distribution and warehousing is increasingly dominated by AGVs. This is a result of the many benefits AGVs have brought to the factory floor, such as decreasing labor costs, increasing safety, accuracy, and productivity. Nevertheless, high investment and maintenance costs still form the main barrier for small and medium-sized enterprises to adopt this technology in their production streams. The requirements imposed on AGVs that enters today's market, and more specifically on its sensors for localization and navigation in highly dynamic environments, are cost effectivity, high position update rates to cope with high driving speeds, and low position errors to perform complex maneuvers. As already mentioned before, this research focuses on the inertial measurement unit, a small electronic device based on MEMS technology that contains accelerometers, gyroscopes, and sometimes magnetometers, temperature and pressure sensors to measure a body's acceleration, angular rate, and orientation. State-of-the-art IMUs have the advantages of small size and low power consumption, but their precision is low and the position error will accumulate over time. Consequently, sensor fusion with external navigation information is key. And therefore, this research combines inertial and laser scan data through simultaneous localization and mapping, or SLAM, in an indoor production environment. The purpose of this study is to present a systematic quantification of the accuracy under static conditions and dynamic conditions during typical AGV motion, which is, according to our knowledge, only be done for human motion tracking. The examined sensors are three low-cost IMUs with prices ranging from 50 to 250 euros and are manufactured by Sparkfun, Variance, and Babylon Fuchs. These are compared to one medium-cost IMU from Xsens, which costs about 4,000 euros. Their main characteristics are listed in the table shown on this slide, and the IMUs were interfaced using the open source drivers in the robot operating system, or ROS. A hookup guide, as well as a source code over self-developed drivers for the Babylon Fuchs IMU, can be found on our GitLab server. For the static analysis, the four IMUs were placed on an acrylic platform and mounted on the end effector of the KUKA IWA collaborative robot. The setup is shown in the figure on the right, and in order to limit the environmental influences, such as vibrations, the cobot was placed in a kinematically rigid configuration. During the analysis, the sensor platform's normal was placed horizontally and captured raw accelerometer and gyroscope data, as well as sensor fuse orientation data for 13 hours. Subsequently, the overlapping Allen variance method was used to determine noise terms such as the white noise, bias offset, and bias instability. The picture on the left shows the typical output, which consists of the island deviation plot with the most interesting regions highlighted. The following table lists the root mean square value of the noise terms for respectively the IMU's accelerometers and gyroscopes. The Pebble and Fuchs IMU was an in-development prototype and unfortunately gave an unusable output as a result of the sensor fusion algorithm that derails due to sudden high acceleration peaks. For this reason, the Pebble and Fuchs IMU was not included in the static analysis. According to the results, the Variance and Xsense IMUs gave respectively the worst and best results with regard to the noise term analysis of their accelerometers, although with only small differences between the SparkFun and Variance IMU. Regarding the noise term analysis of the gyroscopes, an opposite result can be concluded. Namely, the Variance IMU is showing the best result and the Xsense IMU the worst. For the dynamic analysis, the sensor platform was again mounted on the cobots and the effector, but this time with the normal placed vertically to simulate AGV operation. To examine the frequency response, the sensor fuse orientation data of the four IMUs was recorded for 45 seconds, with the last robot joint performing a sinusoidal rotation about the sensor platform's normal axis. Subsequently, the IMUs are evaluated by comparing the amplitude difference and phase shift between the actual sinusoidal rotation of the cobots and effector and the recorded IMU data. When we take back the AGV use case in mind, this amplitude difference and phase shift represent respectively a deviation and a time delay when determining the AGV's pose after performing an angular rotation. The step response, on the other hand, was realized by linearly rotating the robot's last joint and suddenly pressing the emergency stop. The slope and the drift of the obtained signals for the four IMUs were qualitatively compared to each other. The following table enumerates the results for the frequency response. The first column contains data related to the cobot's motion that served as a reference for the IMU metrics. The frequency of the robot's motion was varied between 1 and 10 Hz, and the relative frequency differences, amplitude differences, and phase shifts of the IMU's orientation data were determined. Judging by the general colors, the three IMUs score equally well, with only small mutual variations. At higher frequencies, it was found that the shape of the angular data deviated from a sinus, which made it more difficult to programmatically determine the extrema. This can be the cause of the apparent improved amplitude differences at a frequency of 10 Hz. This figure depicts the IMU's angle over time with the robot performing a linear rotation. After a certain amount of time, a sudden stop was induced, which caused the step response. A significant overshoot of the SparkFun's IMU data compared to the other IMU's data is observed. Besides this, the Variance and Xsense IMUs show slight drifts over time. Before the evaluation of four IMUs in the AGV and map building use case, a 2D SLAM algorithm needs to be selected. In this benchmark study, the generated maps of four frequently used SLAM algorithms, G-mapping, Hector SLAM, Cartographer, and Tiny SLAM, are evaluated based on a visual map inspection and three quantitative metrics. Hector SLAM was included to evaluate the need of sensor fusion for indoor mapping, since it only requires laser scan data, while G-mapping, Tiny SLAM, and Cartographer require laser scan data as well as movement data. For this evaluation, the mapping of a long corridor was chosen, because this is, according to the literature, a challenging environment to map, due to the likeliness of consecutive laser scan and movement data. In order to ascertain the need for sensor fusion and benchmark different IMUs, an AGV setup was constructed as depicted below. Data of the four aforementioned IMUs, together with Hokuyo laser scan data, were collected simultaneously for two different environments using Cartographer. The first environment represents an industrial setting with several injection molding machines. The second environment contains a challenging long corridor. Light and dark pixels represent free and occupied space respectively, with intermediate grayscale values indicating uncertain areas in the map of the SLAM algorithm. In order to determine the influence of IMU-based sensor fusion data on map building, the same three evaluation metrics as previously described it are considered. The shown table states that Spark from IMU is constantly outperformed by the other devices. However, the results of the remaining three IMUs do not display large variations. This indicates that based on these relative metrics, no conclusive decisions can be made regarding the IMU choice for navigating in the proposed environment. The influence of the IMU on the map building process can be evaluated by comparing the generated absolute distances to a ground truth. The environment containing a long corridor was chosen to evaluate the estimated size and length of the generated map. During the movement through a long corridor, the laser scanner receives similar consecutive data. This makes it difficult for the SLAM algorithm to determine the translational movement of the AGV. In such a situation, the information of the IMU becomes imperative to estimate the movements of the vehicle. Although all maps are reasonably well constructed, the XSense and Variance IMU outperform the Peplin-Fuchs and the Sparkfun IMU. A noticeable difference with the previous relative evaluation is that the Sparkfun IMU outperforms the Peplin-Fuchs IMU in this case. This paper presents the benchmarking of three low-cost and one medium-cost IMU, based on a static and dynamic analysis, as well as an indoor use case regarding SLAM of an industrial production environment. The static analysis concludes that concerning the accelerometer and gyroscope data, the XSense and Variance IMU respectively perform the best. Subsequently, the dynamic frequency response shows that the three IMUs of Sparkfun, Variance, XSense score equally well. Peplin-Fuchs IMU was not included in either analysis. Besides this, the dynamic step response depicts a significant overshoot of Sparkfun's IMU data. Meanwhile, the Variance and XSense IMU show slight drift over time. Relative evaluation based on the proportion, corner count and enclosed area metrics conclude that Sparkfun IMU is outperformed by the other three IMUs. Due to the small mutual variations, no conclusive decision can be made regarding the selection of IMUs for SLAM in the proposed environment. According to the absolute evaluation, comparing the lengths of the measured corridors and the building plans, the Variance and XSense IMUs outperform the remainder. Nevertheless, map built with the Sparkfun IMU approximates the reality better compared to the Peplin-Fuchs IMU. Finally, it can be stated, with regard to the AGV operation, the low-cost IMUs perform equally well compared to the medium-cost IMUs. In this work, the performance of four different IMUs for SLAM is analyzed by comparing the accuracy of the maps built. Future work could consist of transferring this research to solely 2D localization by comparing the paths obtained by means of adaptive Monte Carlo localization with respect to a ground truth. For instance, an absolute positioning system such as the Marvel Mind indoor navigation system. In addition, the influence of the IMU's underlying sensor fusion algorithm, such as the Kalman filter and its variance and particle filters, could be subject of future research. We have arrived at the end of the presentation. Thank you for watching and we would be happy to answer your questions.
Thank you for your presentation. So for those of you who has just turned in, we're on the second live stream of the SERP-E Global Web Conference 2019. And we have been just listening to the contribution entitled Benchmarking Low-Cost Inertial Measurement Units for Indoor Localization in Navigation of AGVs. We are gonna get a connection to our authors now. So, can you hear me?
Hello.
So, we have Martin and Jurien Kramer with us, and as well as your colleagues, as I can see, right?
Yes.
Hi to everyone. So I have a couple of questions regarding your paper, which we can discuss within the next few minutes with all of you. And please feel free to answer all of you as you feel comfortable with it. First question is, since you work a lot also in applied research projects, how is this benchmarking work related to industrial applications?
So this research was a part of a larger project, as you say, a technology transfer project called Ad Usum Navigantium. In that project, we analyzed different sensors, LiDAR scanners on use in the inertial measurement units, as well as SLAM algorithms. We also built a sensor platform to map different environments, outdoor environments as well as indoor environments. And we also built a simulator tool for industry and for the companies to test their setup in different environments. And in that project, we worked with a consortium of different companies of Belgian industry, ranging from the food sector to HV of technology suppliers, and many different companies. And for also in this research, we worked with different research groups within our university to have different views on the topic or on the research in front of us. For example, we worked with Group D in Leuven. They use the technology in this project to map harbors for inland shipping and also to map waterways on a boat.
Thank
using
you.
Technology.
Benchmarking in the sense of collaboration with multiple companies from the same sector is a challenging issue because of the let's say intellectual property of each collaborator. So how do you deal with multiple companies in such projects?
So we didn't do a specific use case for the companies. In this project, we wanted to build a generic solution for all the companies. Didn't work out a specific solution for a specific company, but instead a generic solution for all the companies from which all the companies can benefit.
Okay. And since you are from the Department of Mechanical Engineering, do you also collaborate with other departments or other institutes, maybe research institutes?
Yes, we collaborated in this project with Group D, another research group. Also with in other projects, we also work together with other universities or with other departments from computer sciences or computer sciences or additive manufacturing and so on. So we work frequently together with other research groups as well as other universities for our research.
Thanks a lot. And what are the next steps from your perspective in this field of research?
Maybe I can pass this question to our SLAM expert.
Yes, sure.
Basically, we benchmark the IMUs for SLAM, so simultaneous localization and mapping. But the next step will be to expand this research to solely localization. So to set up a ground truth measurement for the position of the IMU, and then check different algorithms for localizing your sensor platform based on the IMU movements alone. So that's one trajectory we can pursue. But another is to go further on the SLAM approach and go from the 2D to the 3D SLAM approach and check whether different IMUs have different effects in certain areas for applications further down the road.
Okay, sounds interesting. Thank you also for your answer. So I would like to thank to all of you and hope to you soon see again. And Again, good luck also for the next year for the CRPE Global Web Conference, for the organizing it.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye.